Hello.
What's up?
How are you?
Ooh, is this fancy?
We got a little magic window background.
I can.
Whole
this
world.
This is so cool.
This sounds cool.
I don't know when I keep this.
Is this your first time on set?
I feel like you might should have been
on
here
this
before.
Set. I don't think I actually shot anything on this set, and they like in this room. Yeah.
Crazy.
But just kidding. Maybe I did. Spoilers.
Spoilers by abstinence. Spoilers.
Like, yeah.
I don't know what I am and who I am. What's going on?
Spoiler by default. I don't know.
Hi, I'm Koi Jandro here with Red Carpet Report, and I'm on the set of Runaways Season 2 with the entire enormous ensemble cast and the producers to talk about everything that's to come on December 21st, and oh, I'm excited.
Season 2 ruined. You're like, I've never seen the house. Oh, no.
You're like, what's Gert?
Were the cameras rolling? Where's Gert been? She was running away.
Running away from the Runaways. It's the most meta show you've ever
just
seen.
Just you and Lace running through the countryside. It's like a rom-com.
I'd watch that.
The Notebook 2, Old Lace and Gert. So, hello. It's good to meet you. I'm Koi.
Cool to be
pleasure.
Here.
Hey, I'm excited to see your spinoff of The Notebook 2.
I'm so excited. I don't know how on board I am with the bestiality aspect
that's
of
true,
that.
That's true. That's fair. There's a connotation I didn't imply.
Yeah,
I'm like,
yeah.
I was just thinking romantic overtures, but then it got dark.
I mean, friendship can be romantic in a sense.
That's true. And like the young adult tone. You
yeah,
could definitely have a
totally.
Gallivanting.
Coming of age.
Yeah, you could have the
road
Lady and the
movie.
Tramp moment with the spaghetti.
But we
like,
don't kiss. Yeah.
I like that.
Cool.
And it's with a dinosaur.
And it's with the dinosaur, so it's cool.
So you get to work opposite a dinosaur.
I do.
What was it like the first day you met Old Lace in person?
The first day I met Old Lace in person was actually the day I had that panic attack scene in season 1, episode 3.
Okay.
So I was very in my head about it.
Yeah.
I met her, but I was also kind of constantly freaking out on set. So I was just kind of staring at her. I didn't really. I think I took a couple little selfies. My mom was also, both my parents were on set that day. And I didn't realize that that would be an overwhelming day to bring your parents. You know, you have
panic
to have a panic attack,
dinosaur.
You meet a dinosaur. Exactly. So they were like, why aren't you hanging out with us? And I was like, because I'm freaking out.
There's a lot going on, Mom.
Yeah. Exactly.
So when you found out you got Runaways, obviously the Marvel Universe has been shaped over the last 10 years. You've seen the explosion of it. You're of the generation where Iron Man being in a movie is like, this is the standard.
Yeah.
What was it like when you found out you were part of the biggest family in movies and TV?
It was kind of unreal. It was one of those where I think it's still slowly hitting me. I really can't even say there was a moment where it hit me. Like, I remember my manager called and she was like, Jeff Loeb from Marvel is going to call you with Josh and Stephanie. Be ready for a conference call. I didn't realize this meant 3 hours later, so I sat in my bed for 3 hours, kind of just staring at a wall, knowing I couldn't tell anyone.
Oof.
So I didn't realize it would be 3 hours. I was literally just sitting up in my bed, didn't eat, didn't do anything. By the time Jeff called, it had been so anticipated that I didn't let him finish a single sentence. I was just like, yep, yes, yes, awesome, cool.
Negotiations the Marvel way. Yes, please. Okay.
Tomorrow. Was no negotiating. Just like I'll pay you. Okay.
We'll figure it out later. We'll fix it in post. So you're now part of this world. Do you follow the other movies, the comics, the TV? Are you like a fan as well as?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, Marvel was kind of a formative thing for me because it happened. The first Avengers movie came out when I was in sixth grade, I think, and my friends like dressed up to go to the movies, and it really became a part of my life. Like, I don't remember a part of my life where Marvel wasn't kind of just looming over me. Like,
that's
there
incredible.
Was something coming, and I always kind of dreamt that I could join the Marvel Universe maybe after I win an Oscar, because that kind of seemed to be the trajectory. Like, only the best of the best get to be in Marvel. So to kind of short line that one was cool.
Happened a little earlier than on the trajectory.
I didn't have to win an Oscar.
That's next now. You can switch
it
up.
Yeah. I'm building my way up to that now.
So Gert's an incredibly strong character. She's very strong-willed. She speaks her mind. Mm-hmm. Is that something you enjoy as a character you get to play? Do you like being the forceful one of the team or one of the forces?
Yeah, it's really fun, especially because it gives me as Ariella kind of leeway on set to not have a filter, because I'm like, it's the character, like, I'm in character, and Josh and Steph have kind of gotten the most of that. I'll text or call them at any hour to be like, this line, I was thinking about it. I mean, I've never had a legitimate critique of their lines, because it's always solid, they know what they're talking about, but I'll just call to be like, you know, I was thinking with my version of feminist that I grew up with when I was in high school, this would be kind of what I say, and they were like, Yeah, for sure. They're always very polite about it because I ramble.
And you get to be that for an entire generation. Like,
which
this is
crazy.
Genre redefined. Yeah. How does that feel walking around knowing that there's so many kids that look to you for that guidance?
It's weird because in a way it feels mutual because I don't think I'm really doing anything spectacular for anyone. I'm doing exactly what I want to do. Mm-hmm. And then people message me saying they feel less alone and they feel seen. And then I get to feel less alone because people are reaching out to me. And it's exciting. I just get to do a thing I've always wanted to do and also find a community within that. And I don't feel like it's me like becoming a martyr for anyone. It's kind of, it's nice. It's actually a really nice experience.
That's perfect. Yeah. That's great. Now, in the comics and in the show now, and we'll see it evolve in season two, you and Greg are together.
Oh,
in season two, without spoilers per se, how does that evolve? How does that fit the story? What's it like running away dating?
I can tell you, I cannot tell you the details, but I can tell you it does not turn out the way you would expect, and I like that.
Okay.
It's a very unpredictable storyline, but it's very real and it's very human, which is something I appreciate because what happens between us doesn't necessarily happen line by line in the comics, mm-hmm. but it's so human the way we both react to each other under these like dire circumstances, and you get to see like two scared teens being real with each other. And there are the superhero moments, but there are the young people just trying to get by moments, which I've lived, and I know a lot of people living right now are living, and it's nice. I really like the route the writers took with this, and it's been lovely to do with Greg.
All right, my last question for you.
Yes.
Runaways is a cult classic comic. It is in comic lore so deep-seated. Did, when you read the comic and saw yourself as that character, now when you read it, can you hear your voice as these characters? Do you see your friends as these roles? Have you put, like, the actors in place of the, you know what I mean?
I don't know. I don't think so. I think there's very much a comic book girt that I deliberately didn't try to kind of do an impression of. Okay. I let Gert kind of, because I was playing Gert, Gert is me. So, like, TV Gert is me. She's in my bones. That is what Gert is to me. But in the comics, there's, I think she's her own thing, and I pull from it, for sure. Like, the inspiration is all there, but she is kind of, I mean, the voice is different with writing and television. It's going to be different. So there's something about comic art that has stayed very pure to me that I love, and I go to her when I need the advice, you know?
That's perfect.
Yeah.
And I like that they feel separate. I'm a big fan of the book, and I can be surprised by the show. I'm excited for season two.
I mean, when you put a real, living, breathing person behind words, the context, the connotations are all going to change.
Yeah.
You know? But I like that we can coexist and support each other.
I like that you walk that very difficult line. That's a very tricky character to make likable, so congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
I love the book, and I love the show. Congrats.
Thanks so much.
Absolutely.
Great talking with you.
Pleasure to meet you. I'm hand sweaty, so I wanted to like...
So I've been Koi Jandro. The cast is incredible. So many of them know and love comics. If you like this video, click like, subscribe for more, and hunt me down on Twitter, @KoiJandro. And thank you so much. I cannot wait for Runaways. Appreciate it.